If you are a young federal employee, you are going to want to listen up to make sure you understand. There are three things that I'm going to talk about today that are crucial to understand when it comes to being a young federal employee and making sure that you get the most out of your career and you can retire as early as you can and as confidently and comfortably as you possibly can. Now, what do I mean when I say young? Well, it depends. And really though, these three principles and ideas I'm going to share today are going to be the most relevant for those that are not going to be retiring here in the next few years, right? But a young federal employee can be anyone from, let's say, their 20s, 30s, 40s, even 50s, depending on when you want to retire, okay? So if you've got some time until retirement, then this is certainly going to speak to you. Now, maybe you are closer to retirement, but these three things, you're certainly going to want to have a plan for, but I hope you would already have when you're close to retirement. So let's dive right in. Thing number one, the idea and principle number one that you have to understand as a young federal employee is you have to know perfectly well what your career goals are. And you have to plan with the end in mind, okay? Your work has a couple of goals when you go to work, okay? Now, I can't speak for you. You may have different goals, but these are the general goals that people have. First, you work to pay the bills in the short term, right? To put food on the table, to eat, to live. You work to get a paycheck. That's number one, okay? Number two, you work to put money away for the future. So someday, you can stop working. You can actually retire. So with that in mind, you want to make sure that your job is filling both of those things, right? Both of those things, so that you can have the lifestyle that you want now, but also that you can retire when you want to. Now, how is that relevant for a federal employee? Well, as a federal employee, there's a big thing called a minimum retirement age, which for most of you is going to be right around age 57, okay? Now, if you are a special provisions FERS, right? Firefighters, air traffic controllers, you folks, you know who you are, right? Then potentially you could retire after 25 years or at age 50, so potentially earlier than the regular traditional FERS. But if you're a regular traditional FERS employee, then 57 is really the earliest you can retire and get benefits, right? Get a pension, right? Now, you can retire before that with a deferred retirement. You could look at some of my other videos and articles on that. But the bottom line is, your minimum retirement age, which is around 57, is really a really, really big breaking point where a lot of things will start, whether it's pensions, whether it's keeping your health insurance. There's a lot of things that really are just around age 57. So if you're in your 20s, 30s, and you don't want to work until 57, then what are your plans? What are your plans? You have to be realistic. Like, okay, do I want to spend 30 years as a government employee, right? And I know a ton of people that do that, and then they love it, and it's a great career path for them, right? But is that what you want, right? If you don't want that retirement deal, then maybe it's not a good fit for you. But, of course, there's other factors. There's definitely other factors, right? Maybe you can go get a similar job in the private sector, but are the hours going to be as good, right? Is the pay going to be as good? Maybe it'll be better. Do they have a pension? Do they have great health benefits? Do they allow you to keep your health benefits into retirement? These are all the questions that you have to ask when you consider to say, okay, do I want to stay with the government for the rest of my career? Do I want to leave? What do I want to do? These are the questions, especially as a young federal employee, you want to answer as soon as you possibly can, right? Because often people wait until they get into the middle of their career where they're kind of in this purgatory, this middle ground where, you know, they're not old enough to retire, but they really don't like what they do, so they're kind of stuck. They could go somewhere else, but they can't go anywhere else and really have enough time to build up substantial retirement, so they're really stuck with the federal government until they're eligible to retire. Now, being stuck with the federal government's not a bad gig, right? The job security's great. There's a ton of benefits. You just have to know, okay, what makes sense for you? When do you want to retire, and does the government have options for that, right? Does it make sense for your plan? And obviously, if you're young, if you're in 20s and 30s, the rules may change, but it's your responsibility to stay up on those rules so that you know when you can retire and what that's going to look like. Again, if you're young, retirement may not even be on your brain, but it should be, at least in the back of your brain, right? And that takes us to the next piece. If you're a young federal employee, especially, now, this certainly applies to those that are nearing retirement as well, you have to get your TSP in gear. When you are young, what you do when you're young, honestly, has more of an effect than what you do right before retirement. Because if for every dollar you put into your TSP while you're young, it has so many more years to compound, to grow, right? So the power of compound interest is incredibly strong, especially when you're young. Now, when you are older, you often are making more money, you can put more away, so there's advantages when you're older and nearing retirement as well. But a huge advantage that those nearing retirement don't have is a ton of time before retirement. So you want to get your TSP in check. Save as much as you can. You don't want to be unreasonable, but just save as much as you possibly can. And especially if you're young, depending on what your income is, consider the Roth TSP, right? Because every dollar you put into the Roth TSP, assuming you follow all the rules, right? It has so much more time to grow, and all of that money that you put in, plus all the money it grew to, can come out tax-free out of the Roth TSP if you start using it early. Number three has to do with some of your insurances. First, the first one, and honestly the most important one as a young federal employee, is of course you need your health insurance. You want to make sure that is you have a good plan for you, but also life insurance. What life insurance do you need, right? And you have to start looking at the long term. You have to start looking like, okay, maybe I'm young and single right now, but am I planning to get married? Am I planning to buy a house? Am I planning to have kids? How is my situation going to change? Am I going to be paying off debt, right? We have to look for the next 5, 10, 15, even 20 years plus, right? So, okay, what is my situation going to look like in the future? And what do I need to do now to make sure I'm good to go? Now, for example, life insurance is one of those things that the earlier you get it, the better rates you generally can get, right? And of course, there's the life insurance you can get through your job as a federal employee, the FEGLI. There's a lot of great options, especially if you're young. But just know, as you get older, into your 50s, 60s, it gets very expensive to keep Part B of FEGLI, right? The basic option stays pretty consistent throughout your career, but the Part B gets very expensive, so just keep that in mind as you get older, that it may not be the best solution forever. So how much life insurance do you think you're gonna need now and over the next 5, 10, 15, 20 years? And find the right insurance, whether through the government or outside the government, that are going to fill those gaps for you so that you have everything in place that you need. So again, those are my thoughts for you young folks out there looking to make plans for the future. So I hope that was helpful. And again, we are really trying to get these videos, this podcast, out to as many federal employees as we possibly can, because we have heard comments time and time again how this information is really helping people, right? And enabling them to learn, and they feel so much more confident and competent about their retirement knowledge, and that they're so much better off for retirement because of these videos and podcasts. So please consider subscribing. Join. If you find value here, then join the community, and it is a great place to learn and get the most out of your retirement. So have a great rest of your day. We'll talk to you soon.